Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 23rd of December. Indian farmers want to intensify agitation against new farm laws on Farmers' Day. Pakistan's coronavirus cases soared past 462,000 amid second wave. And Nepal's ruling party appears headed for split amid power tussle. And now for all the details. Thousands of farmers protesting against the new farm laws want to intensify their agitation on Wednesday on the occasion of National Farmers' Day. A deadlock continues to persist as farmers want the law scrapped, while the government has offered to resume talks to resolve the impasse.
Thousands of farmers on Wednesday want to intensify their agitation demanding rollback of three new farm laws on the occasion of the birth anniversary of India's former Prime Minister Chaudhary Charan Singh, which is celebrated as Kisan Divas or National Farmers' Day. Farmers performed Havan, a fire ritual at the Delhi-Uttar Pradesh border in Ghazipur on the occasion, while farmer leaders called on their supporters to skip one meal on Wednesday in solidarity with the protest that entered 28th day. A deadlock continues to persist as farmers want the laws that liberalize agriculture sector be scrapped, while the government has offered to amend them after holding talks.
Hum tab tak ladenge jab tak hamari baat nahi mani jayegi. चाहे उसके लिए कुछ भी टाइम लग जाए, कितना भी टाइम लग जाए, उसकी कोई सीमा हमारे पास नहीं है। ये सरकार को देखना है और हम सरकार को जनता की आवाज सुननी चाहिए, अगर जनता ने बनाया है और जनता के लिए है।
Meanwhile, amid the protests, Confederation of NGOs of Rural India submitted over 3.1 million signatures from across the country in support of the farm laws to India's Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar on Wednesday. The government has indicated while it is ready for talks for amendments, it will not repeal the laws.
India recorded 23,950 new coronavirus infections in the last 24 hours, taking its total cases to 10.1 million on Wednesday. Daily cases have been dipping steadily in India since hitting a peak in September. Meanwhile, ahead of the Christmas and New Year celebrations, Karnataka government has declared night curfew in the southern state as a precautionary step amid growing concerns over a new coronavirus variant spreading in Britain. Earlier, neighbouring Maharashtra also announced a similar move. A day after India reported the lowest single-day spike in 173 days since the virus outbreak, the country witnessed a slight surge in fresh COVID-19 infections with 23,950 new cases recorded in the last 24 hours. The overall cases in the country have now reached 10.1 million. Amid growing concerns over a new coronavirus variant spreading in Britain, Southern Karnataka state government declared night curfew from Wednesday in the state as a precautionary step ahead of the Christmas and New Year celebrations. Earlier on Monday, neighbouring Maharashtra state had declared a night curfew in municipal corporation areas as a precautionary step.
In view of the new strain 19 virus and as per the advice of Government of India and Technical Advisory Committee, it is decided to impose night curfew from today till 2nd January 2021 between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Meanwhile, the centre on Tuesday assured that there is no reason for panic, noting that the new strain of novel coronavirus has not been seen in India. In the latest, reports suggest that India is likely to approve Oxford AstraZeneca's coronavirus vaccine for emergency use by next week, after its local manufacturers submitted additional data sought by authorities. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's coronavirus cases tally climbed over 462,800 on Wednesday, with more than 9,550 deaths reported so far. In the wake of the highly infectious new coronavirus strain in Britain, Pakistan has also closed its borders to the country. Meanwhile, amid a second wave of the pandemic, the Christian community in Pakistan is gearing up to celebrate a somber Christmas.
As coronavirus infection numbers continue to climb in Pakistan, the country reported a total of 462,814 confirmed cases on Wednesday, with 9,557 deaths, as 2,142 fresh cases with 84 fatalities were registered in the past 24 hours. Pakistan has joined a slew of countries who have closed their borders to Britain, while updating standard operating procedures for travel restrictions over fears of a highly infectious new coronavirus strain in the United Kingdom. Meanwhile, as the Christian community in Pakistan prepares to celebrate a somber Christmas amid a second wave of the pandemic, residents of Karachi and nearby towns, including clerics of various faiths, joined in the annual Santa Claus parade in the port city earlier this week.
We have all the communities here, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, transgenders, all kind of people we have here in our gathering. We want to celebrate Christmas together because Jesus Christ came for the whole world.
Yet, as the jubilant crowd rode through various streets of the city in trucks, bikes and camel carts while dancing and singing Christmas carols, not everyone was wearing a mask.
More news from Pakistan. At least 8 people were killed and 28 injured when a boiler at an ice factory exploded in Pakistan's southern city of Karachi on Tuesday. The roof of the factory building, located in an industrial area of the northern part of the city, collapsed with the force of explosion, killing and injuring workers. Nearby factories were also damaged. Rescue teams worked well into the night, pulling dead and injured from beneath the debris and moving them to hospital. Up to 38 laborers were present at the factory when the incident took place. The commissioner of Karachi, Naveed Ahmed Sheikh, said,
28 injured ko hum shift kar chuke hain hospitals mein. 8 ki death ho chuki hai as for aur baaki jo do critical hain jina aur humne abati shahid hospital bheje hue hain. Maine unko ye hidayat di hai ki ye jo yahan ki management aur jo yahan ke industrial area ke jo president unhone bataya tha ki 36 se 38 ke kareeb yahan pe labor kaam kar rahi thi. Is hisab se agar dekha jaye to humne mostly retrieve kare, मगर मैंने फिर भी इनको हिदायत दी है कि आप ऑपरेशन जारी रखें, बिकॉज़ यू नेवर नो खुदा ना खास्ता कोई और भी जो अंदर स्ट्रैंडेड हो उनको निकाल सकें।
मूविंग ऑन टू न्यूज़ फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान, द यूएस एक्टिंग सेक्रेटरी ऑफ डिफेंस क्रिस्टोफर मिलर ऑन ट्यूसडे मेड अ सरप्राइज ट्रिप टू अफगानिस्तान अमिड राइजिंग वायलेंस एंड द ऑनगोइंग ड्रो डाउन ऑफ यूएस ट्रूप्स इन द वॉर टॉर्न कंट्री. Miller, upon arrival, met Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, where the two discussed the importance of achieving a reduction in violence to advance the Afghan peace process.
The U.S. Acting Secretary of Defense Christopher Miller on Tuesday paid an unannounced visit to Afghanistan, where he held a meeting with Afghan President Ashraf Ghani. Miller and Ghani, during their meeting in Afghan capital Kabul, discuss the historic opportunity for peace, the continued U.S. support for Afghan forces, and the importance of achieving a reduction in violence to advance the Afghan peace process, the Pentagon informed in a statement. Miller's visit to Afghanistan comes amid rising violence and the ongoing drawdown of U.S. troops in the war-torn country. In the latest, at least 5 doctors and health workers were killed in a roadside bomb blast in Kabul on Tuesday, while they were on their way to the office situated inside the country's largest prison. However, the Taliban said they were not involved in the attack. The war in Afghanistan, which has caused about 2,400 U.S. military deaths, is the longest one in U.S. history. The Pentagon last month confirmed that U.S. troops in Afghanistan would be reduced to 2,500 level by mid-January 2021.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Conflict within the ruling Nepal Communist Party and its co-chairs Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli and Pushpakamal Dahal has widened like never before as the two leaders continue working with their respective factions. Rift within NCP started earlier this year after co-chair Dahal's faction started demanding Oli's resignation as they accused him of always taking arbitrary decisions.
Tensions between ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP and its co-chairs Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli and Pushpakamal Dahal are not showing any signs of settlement as the two leaders seems to be moving forward separately with their own factions. A majority of 315 Central Committee members of NCP on Tuesday voted for disciplinary action against co-chair Oli and replaced him with another leader, Madhav Kumar Nepal. This comes as Nepal's President Vidya Devi Bhandari dissolved Nepal's parliament on December 20th at the request of PM Oli's cabinet and announced that general elections would be held in April and May, more than a year ahead of the schedule. Oli defended his recommendation of dissolving the parliament by saying he was forced to take the decision after few leaders were preparing to bring no confidence motion against him. The Helmadav faction believes Oli's move was unconstitutional and has vowed to fight against it. The Supreme Court of the Himalayan Nation has also decided to send all the writs against the government move of dissolving the parliament to the constitutional bench.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. Bangladesh's cabinet meeting chaired by Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on Monday decided to vaccinate at least 45 million people across the country before May or June. The first shipment of 30 million doses of vaccine from the Serum Institute of India is expected to arrive by late January or early February.
Bangladesh's cabinet on Monday decided to vaccinate at least 45 million people before May or June. In a meeting virtually chaired by Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, the cabinet gave its approval to a proposal to vaccinate a total of 45 million people across the country before May or June. Cabinet Secretary Khandkar Anwarul Islam told reporters that the first shipment of 30 million doses of vaccine from the Serum Institute of India is expected to arrive by late January or early February, while another 60 million doses in May or June. The government is mulling using the expanded program of immunization for COVID-19 vaccination, he said, and training for vaccination has already started. Meanwhile, Bangladesh has so far confirmed 503,501 COVID-19 cases, with the death toll standing at 7,329.
The Somnath Temple in India's western Gujarat state is an important pilgrimage and tourist spot. In a major facelift, authorities are renovating the famous Somnath Temple by installing gold plates on the urns of the temple. Authorities in India's western Gujarat state are renovating the famous Somnath Temple by installing gold plates on the urns of the temple. Workers were seen renovating the temple early this week as 1400 urns were to be installed on the temple building. The work to turn the entire spires golden is expected to be accomplished by 2021 end.
जो एक बड़ा सा घुम्मट होता है, उसके पर पत्थर के कलश लगे हैं, और वहाँ की जो आबो हवा है, उसमें वो पत्थर के कलश को कुछ न कुछ नुकसान होता रहता था, तो उसकी जगह ये जो हमारे कॉपर के कलश लगाए जाए और उसको सुवर्ण मंडित किया जाए, तो उससे समग्र मंदिर जो है
Somnath Temple is an important pilgrimage and tourist spot of India. The temple is considered sacred due to the various legends connected to it. It is one among the 12 Jyotirlingas of Lord Shiva in India. It is believed that Somnath holds the first Jyotirlinga or representation of Lord Shiva. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
सब्सक्राइब टैग टीवी यूट्यूब चैनल एंड प्रेस द नोटिफिकेशन बटन. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.